Hi, everybody. My name is Rafa Lombardino, and this is Translation Confessional. This is a quick message for all tech-oriented translators and interpreters out there. Let me tell you a bit about Appsumo. It's pretty much a hub for different apps and online programs that can help you streamline your work and become more productive and efficient. They have solutions in different categories: client management, marketing, productivity, sales, SEO, social media, and web development. In case you need help putting together a professional website that will make you stand out, they have different deals going on, so you can pay just a fraction of what these apps and programs go for in the real marketplace. Make sure you subscribe to their newsletter so you can stay on top of the new deals and tools that are constantly added up to their list. Well, if you'd like to check out Appsumo yourself, go to this webpage, bit.ly/tc-app-sumo. It's easy to remember. TC for Translation Confessional, then Appsumo. Once again, the webpage is bit.ly/tc-app-sumo. Hope you like it. How to manage large projects. Today, I wanted to do something a bit different. Instead of talking about a translation-related subject from scratch, I'll be reading an article written by a fellow translator, Jorge Davidson, who is an English and Portuguese to Spanish translator, proofreader, editor, MT post-editor, and instructor, besides working as a project manager, translator, and editor at Ponto e Coma. He originally wrote an article in Portuguese for his LinkedIn profile, and it was so in sync with what I would have written that I asked him if I could translate it into English to feature it here. We also posted the English translation on the blog of the American Translators Association Portuguese Language Division. I'll add links to the original Portuguese and the English version here to this episode's description, so you can read Jorge's article or my translation. I've just received a 50,000-word project. What now? The challenges posed by large volume projects. After talking to a fellow freelance translator who had just received information about a potential large project, I thought of trying to summarize the things we must keep in mind when sending a quote or accepting a project with these characteristics. Once the other basic considerations have been accounted for, such as whether the client is a good payer, the decision on whether it's worth taking on such a large project, I believe, comes down to four factors: price, deadline, whether you work by yourself or with a colleague, and an array of subjects that I'll classify as miscellaneous. Each of these factors has its unique weight, since they are contingent upon a variety of circumstances. Number one, price. As a starting point, let's assume that all translators have a regular price per word, which may be set in stone or fluctuate within a given range. Considering that, when I analyze a large volume project, I simply multiply my regular price by the number of words that need translation. Is the final figure overwhelming? Well, it's simply a natural consequence of there being so many words needing translation. Now, whether the client has that kind of translation budget or is willing to part ways with all that money, that's a topic for another day. Some translators are stunned by such a high price and may be tempted to apply discounts. The way I see it, that's a big mistake. If, due to exceptional circumstances, I need to accept a lower price than my regular one to work on any given project, I'd rather do it for smaller projects, never for large volume ones. In accepting a lower price for a large volume, we end up with a full schedule and may miss other opportunities, for example, projects that pay better. All in all, the fact that the project is large does not justify accepting a lower price, even though clients usually use that argument. If you accept a lower price, you need to work more to earn the same amount of money, so you'd be dedicating a lot of time to a badly paid project. After all, translation requires an effort that is directly proportional to the number of words to be translated. Number 2. Deadline. This will always be a crucial factor in the translation equation. Let's assume we are the kind of translator who has direct clients and/or translation agencies that send us work regularly. Being totally booked due to a single project is always a problem, especially if said project will take a long time to be completed, because you probably have to say no to other regular clients, either partially or completely during that time. Let's keep in mind that these regular clients have kept us afloat until now, and if we keep doing things right, they'll continue to send us more work over time, especially when that large volume project is finally done. In other words, I'll hardly decide to dedicate all my time to a single project instead of keeping my regular clients happy in the long term. Large volume projects are perfect when the deadline is really comfortable, so I can still take on other projects at the same time. For example, I can dedicate enough time to the large project to work on 1,500 words per day and have enough time to help other clients. That way, this large project is in the background and I can work more on it or resume it the next day as needed. Still using your inbox to manage your translation jobs? Still doing all of your accounting from Excel? Manually creating your financial reports? Using who knows how many different tools to run your translation business? LSP Expert is a client management, project management, and accounting tool for translators. You can create and send quotes, manage your rates and services for each client, manage projects, and send invoices all from one place. It automatically creates financial reports for you, so you always know the health of your business. Ready to stop wasting time on admin and start spending more time translating? Try LSP Expert for free for 30 days. Just type lsp.expert into your preferred browser and use the code HAFA for 15% off a new yearly subscription. Once again, the code is RAFA. Take control of your translation business admin today. Number 3. Working on your own or with a colleague. One scenario when it comes down to taking on a large volume project is collaborating with a colleague. That way, you don't need to be fully booked and/or sacrifice yourself to translate an absurd amount of words per day. Now, we have several things to consider. First of all, you can delegate tasks to someone else, but not the responsibility for the final quality of the project or for meeting the deadline. That is, the client hired you, and your professional reputation is the one on the line. Considering that, working with colleagues requires you to carefully put together a good team. You must review the work provided by your colleague very closely. You must organize the workflow. You must share resources, that is, translation memories, glossaries, and you must ensure consistency among all the parties involved in the project. All this will imply additional efforts and demand time. So it's more than fair that you should charge extra for your time and effort. Besides, when you hire a colleague, you're also taking eventual financial risks in case your client pays you late or doesn't pay you at all. Number 4. Miscellaneous. Here, I'll list a series of factors that may range from circumstantial to subjective matters. These factors may have more or less weight than price and deadline, which are apparently the most objective elements on this translation equation. This list could be exhaustive, but I'll only cover a few examples. Among the circumstantial factors, we should mention an eventual period of low workload, or the need to earn more money to pay off a debt or a late bill. We could also see large volume projects as an opportunity to get a foot in the door in a segment of our interest, to earn a new client, or to work with a company or organization that we identify with somehow. We can see it as a potential long-term relationship with a new interesting client. We may even approach this project as a personal challenge. In conclusion, is it worth it after all? After listing all these items, I believe it's clear that there's no simple answer to that question. There are endless combinations to the four factors I mentioned, from the worst case scenario, low price, tight deadline, an interesting subject, to the best case scenario, high price, comfortable deadline, interesting subject. There are so many other combinations in the middle of the road that we must consider carefully and without haste. After all, we'd be taking on a project that will demand great effort and stick around our schedule for quite some time. Send me an email at rlombardino@wordawareness.com or leave a voice message on my anchor page. If I get enough feedback and voice messages, I can go back to the subject and post a special podcast episode with everyone's opinion on this very same theme. By the way, my anchor page is anchor.fm/translation-confessional. I look forward to hearing from you. Stay tuned for weekly episodes and subscribe to Translation Confessional through your favorite podcast app.